Hello, my name is Jacob Slammer, and this is the first episode of the CCR Liberty in Detail series. In this series of videos, I would like to take you through the complete CCR Liberty platform and to give you a complete source of information. So after watching all the episodes, you should have a complete understanding of the platform, its function, and the overall philosophy behind it. Each individual episode will describe you a part of the platform, and it will also describe you how and why the things are done the way they are. So in the later episodes, we will talk about each individual configuration, its features, and you will get a complete understanding of everything to be able to choose which unit would be right for you. So in the first episode, we will be talking about where the units are manufactured, the philosophy behind them, and the main variants of the configurations. So the Liberty Rebreathers, as well as the helium and oxygen analyzers, the Divesoft computers, and other high-tech scuba diving equipment are manufactured in Divesoft company, which is located about 40 kilometers north of Prague, the capital of the Czech Republic. The company has its own development and a testing center, and all the products here are designed and made out of scratch. So the whole chain that is necessary for product manufacturing and the development is here under one roof. This includes the research, the development of the electronics and the mechanical parts, and the testing facility, including the quality control. So this allows us to be at every single step of the manufacturing process, and this gives us a complete control over the quality of our products. The company is a crowd of passionate people who love precision, technology, and scuba diving. And this totally reflects in all our products. So you must be asking yourself, how does a company from landlocked Czech Republic end up manufacturing a rebreather? And what's the philosophy behind it then? Well, let me tell you all about it. The Liberty Rebreather was born in mind of Aleš Procházka, who was a member of a team of cave explorers doing cave explorations all over Europe. Aleš couldn't find the rebreather on his market that would suit his needs, so necessity is the mother of invention, so he decided to start designing his own rebreather. The main goal would be to create a fault-tolerant rebreather with enough redundancy whilst maintaining the unit's reliability. At the same time, the unit would have to be easy to be controlled by the diver, and there was also a lot of emphasis put into work of breathing performance of the unit. So the other key factors would be to create a unit that would be fail-safe platform and would be modifiable and modular. So the next important factor would be serviceability. So the diver would have to be able to exchange parts of the unit on the site with a minimum amount of tools. The essential life support function would have to be built in redundancy. So if a component failed, the diver would be able to return home and remain on the loop. When getting quite deep into the cave, it would be unacceptable if the unit just shut down or refused to dive. So then by getting all the crucial systems redundant, in most of the cases, there would always be a way to resolve the problem. And this is exactly what you would want when you're deep in a wreck or very deep in a cave. The unit would have to give you an option to resolve the situation without forcing you to take an action based on a computer's decision. So the diver would be the one responsible for the operation of the unit and the one who would be able to make the calculated decision based on the situation he would be in. There's a saying that beauty is in simplicity, and large amount of elements of the Liberty platform follow this rule. But by making the crucial systems redundant on the unit, we get more safety by getting more options to resolve any potential situation. An aircraft industry has been successfully implementing this philosophy for a long time with a great success. We will get more into detail as we go throughout the series. The next thing is the modularity. As you will see, there's a quite a large variety of what to choose from. At the end, we will look into the individual configurations, but that will be later on in the episodes. Now we're going to have a look at the possible configurations that you can have. So the beauty in the modularity is that we have the same head and we can use the one head for all the configurations. So you can, for example, use this head and have it in a configuration in a back-mounted unit and also for the side-mounted unit. In fact, you can just own one head and have just a conversion kit or a bunch of conversion kits and to convert your unit into whatever you like diving based on your preference. In this case, this standard scrubber canister can also be used in all the configurations that we have. The unit has a bailout mode, so as the head can be shared with all the units can be used as a bailout rebreather. In the back mounted configuration, you can select between the configuration with back mounted counterlugs, or you can select a configuration with a front mounted counterlugs. In a back mounted version, you can also go for Liberty Light version, which is a light soft pack harness, which is ideal for traveling. We also have a heavy version, which can be fitted with any size cylinders. You can also put multiple cylinders on it, and the unit can also be fitted with your own backplate or with our backplate and a standard CCR wing. There are many ways how you can configure the units. When it comes to BOV and the DSV option, in side mount configuration comes with a DSV. In the back mounted configuration, you can choose. So you can either go with DSV as well, or you can go with our BOV. In terms of the scrubbers, we have three sizes of scrubbers. We have 2.0 kilo scrubbers of two types. We have a standard 2.5 kilo scrubber, and we have a short version of our 2.5 kilo scrubber. There's also extra large 3.3 kilo size scrubber, but we'll be looking more into depth of those later on throughout the series. The other thing that you can choose from is the selection of the material of your backplate. So you can either pick between stainless steel or titanium. Same applies to the stand of the unit. You can either go with titanium or with stainless steel, but you can also go for a narrower and shorter stand depending on your posture. All the units come with quite a variety of accessories, but we'll be looking at those down throughout the series. So that's it for our first episode. In the next episode, we'll be talking about the individual parts of the units. For more information, please visit our webpage at divesoft.com, where you can also find our configurator, where you can just go and try to configure the unit for yourself. There's also more information there. And please follow our YouTube channel and our Facebook webpage. For any further questions, please email us at info@divesoft.com. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you next time.